Yeah, yeah, that's it.
Yo!
Unlucky.
Come on.
Oh! Carling, devoted to SPL football on ESPN.
In Scotland and England, league matches, cup matches and even a cup final will be played today. But the news that Fabrice Muamba is still critically ill in hospital after collapsing during yesterday's FA Cup quarter-final between Tottenham and Bolton will be at the forefront of many people's minds. Football fans everywhere will show their support for the 23-year-old Bolton player as he fights for his life. We're at Stamford Bridge, where Chelsea and Leicester will play an FA Cup quarter-final later today. That's part two of a football doubleheader here on ESPN. Part one is an Edinburgh derby. For the 294th time down the years, Hearts and Hibs are preparing to go head-to-head. The occasion and the rivalry demands total commitment. Hearts are targeting their third derby victory of this season in their push for a top-four finish. More problems over delayed wages have to be put to one side. The priority is to protect a nine-game unbeaten run against Hibs. It's the Jambos' best record in derby matches for 18 years. So Hibs will be totally focused on bringing that run to an end, and the points are so precious given their fighting relegation. Stay up and win the cup. That's the target for the Easter Road Club, and they'd love to win a derby match. Let's look at the table. Hearts will kick off sixth. A win will go close to securing a top half finish. A top four finish guarantees European football at Tynecastle next season. Second bottom Hibs only 4 points above Dunfermline, who have parted company with Jim McIntyre with 8 games to go. Hibs' place in the top flight of Scottish football by no means guaranteed. On the back of another Rangers defeat yesterday, Celtic need 4 points for the title now. Only goal difference puts the Jers above Motherwell. All the goals from yesterday's games are coming up in the build-up to kick off at Tynecastle. So Stamford Bridge is base camp. Right on the back of the Hearts-Hibs derby will be the FA Cup quarter-final between Chelsea and Leicester. John Collins alongside Craig Burley. So let's look at this derby match, and as we look ahead to this, how do you see Hearts' chances of finishing in the top four? That's their average since the SPL was introduced. Do you see them doing this? Do you see them catching those other clubs?
I think they're going to have a good end to the season. I think they're capable of it. They've got a decent squad of players, but they've lost the last two home games in the league. Hibs, on the other hand, are fighting to pull away from that second bottom place, try and catch the teams above them. Got a semi-final to look forward to. I think the confidence has come back in recent weeks to Hibs. Harder to beat. Not conceding soft goals, but the home team always going to be slight favourites.
What level of concern do you have for Hibs' situation? Do you see a Dunfermline revival? Do you think Hibs will stay up?
I think they will stay up, but obviously they've given Jim McIntyre has been given the boot or has been sacked, so that's not an ideal scenario for him. And obviously it's been a very difficult job. They may bring in some experience. John was talking earlier, it could be a kind of Jim Jeffries scenario or maybe something like that. So there may be a revival there, but they'll have to work with what they've got. So, and what Hibs will want to do as well, Ray, they want to give themselves a little bit of breathing space and a little bit of leeway. They've got 4 points at the moment, so that's a win and a draw. But if Dunfermline do pick up, it could be in a perilous position. So they need to pick some points up and pick them up quick.
Last manager to lead Hibs to a trophy. Is it red alert or amber alert for you for Hibs' situation?
I think it's amber just now. I think Dunfermline are really struggling to pick up points. Hibs, on the other hand, the last couple of weeks, tighter at the back, scoring goals. I think getting to that semi-final gives the club a lift. The fans can look forward to that. But I think if they can create that a little bit bigger gap between themselves and Dunfermline, it can be a more relaxed running. But 4 points, it's still all to play for, but I still think that they should now pull away from the bottom.
Derby match, big game. Over to Derek Ray now. Let's get the team news.
Thank you, Ray. Well, Hearts' big problem of late has been one of leaking goals. They haven't recorded a clean sheet in the SPL in the calendar year of 2012. They are minus key defender Marius Zaliukas today. The big Lithuanian is serving a suspension. Darren Barr gets the nod in central defence. Jamie Hamill returns from his one-match ban and is preferred to Ryan McGowan. Adrian Mrowiec, I can tell you, is out today with a knee injury. Hasn't even made it onto the bench. Rudy Scatchell plays from the start in what looks like an attack-minded Hearts team. Now, Hibs are minus two important players who are serving suspensions, namely Isaiah Osborne and Ivan Sproul. In have come David Wotherspoon and Tom Soares, who makes his first appearance for 3 weeks and is one of six Derby debutants in the Hibs side. Frankham, McPake, Kujabi, Claros and O'Donovan are the others. Delighted to welcome Stephen Cragan, who'll join me for commentary here at Tynecastle today. Stephen, a few months ago, it was pretty clear Hearts had the bigger, better squad. Can we say that now in the light of the January overhaul of Pat Fenlon and Hibs?
Well, probably not. You know, I think around the Christmas period, Hearts had a great turn of form. They pushed themselves up the league. Hibs were struggling. But since Pat Fenlon's come in, Derek, he's brought in a lot of players. And I think that's... It always takes time for players to settle into the formation, settle into the manager's plans. And sometimes it's tough with one or two, but I think it's been a case of six or seven for Pat. So he's maybe just starting now to see the benefits. I think they've turned the corner a little bit. 3 points today would be huge for them. You know, I think 7 points for Dunfermline to make up when they're not winning games, they're not winning at home, they haven't got a manager, could be a long way back. So, you know, this is a vital game for both sides. Hearts going for top four in European football, Hibs just trying to stay in the SPL.
I mentioned Hearts' defensive problems. On the other side of the coin, they have started to score goals recently, encouraging for Paulo Sergio Rey.
Making your debut in this match, how important is that? I think there's quite a few in the Hibs team today.
Well, six. I don't know when the last time a Hibs-Hearts derby had six debutants in the one team. So I think it's important they start the game well. Two of the back four, James McPake, he's come in, he's captain. He's sound, solid, a good talker at the back. Little left back, Kujabi. Terrific going forward, but I think he's about 5'4", so I think Hearts will be trying to exploit his size at the back post, looking for diagonals onto Beattie. So I think McPeak's got a big responsibility. When the balls come in, he's got to be looking for Beattie. He can't leave a little Kujabi at the back post to take care of him. So that's a big part of the game, and I'm sure you'll see Hearts looking to exploit that.
The Hearts wages are late again. Issue or not an issue? It's nothing new. It's happened a while. But on this occasion, there was a statement from the club blaming the fringe players for not leaving the club in January. What was your reaction to that?
Well, it's just an absolute nonsense, isn't it? I mean, you cannot give players contracts, as Hearts have. You've got fringe players at every club. You expect them just to go? Don't be so stupid. I mean, it's never been so ridiculous in all my life. The trouble is, this owner's came in a few years ago, talked about winning the Champions League and all this nonsense. They can't even pay the wages at the moment for these guys. They've earned their wages, whether they're fringe players or not. That's the bottom line. They've got families. Some of them might not. You're not just going to go and take a 50% wage cut or a 75% wage cut.
I think the policy of trying to balance expenditure to income is one that sort of all football clubs need to adopt, but it's the way of going about it, surely.
Without a doubt, I don't think you can blame the fringe players. They've been offered contracts, probably too much money, but that's not the players' fault. That's the owners have given them those contracts, and all of a sudden now they want the players to probably clear off and lower wages. So unrealistic expectations from the owners, but you're right. They've got to get the balance between what they bring in and what they spend to try and correct it. But there's a huge deficit at the club, and there's a lot of work to be done.
Correct me if I'm wrong, John. You need fringe players. You can't just have the same 11 on the field week in, week out. It's a little word that Vladimir Romanov might want to look up in the dictionary. It's called squad. You need a squad.
Well, one observation I was thinking, fringe player might be needed in the weeks to come to try and get them to the end of the season and pick up as many points as possible. I think one other thing as well, Hearts have had problems with their financial issues. We wish them well at sorting it out. They're a big club. But the Rangers situation has perhaps overshadowed that in recent weeks. And if we look at Rangers playing again yesterday now, this is another defeat. Dundee United have now four consecutive wins. Rangers have lost three of the last four. But Rangers' situation, on and off the field, going from bad to worse.
Yep, lots of injuries as well, coming at a bad moment, but that is a fantastic strike there. It's absolute no chance the goalkeeper, he's caught that. He couldn't have hit that any better, so it's a great... But Rangers, on the pitch, off the pitch, there's real problems. I think they've got 10 players out injured, so Ali McCoys has got a tough job. Watch this defending here at the back post. The defender's completely on the wrong side, doing absolutely nothing behind John Daly there. They've got to work on it. That's something they've got to be working, defending better. Look at the defender there. He's doing absolutely nothing. He's got to get the other side, ball side of him, and it's an easy tapping. But Dundee United, on the other hand, they're playing really well. The manager, I think, has done a terrific job.
Three Rangers players in the box, one United player, John Daly. Super ball in. It was always going to be a tough game, this, John, for Rangers when it got up to Tannadice. You mentioned they're on the up, Dundee United. Great skill from Aluko. Huge slice of luck as it takes a deflection, but he did well to wriggle himself into that position. I was really surprised when Rangers signed him, but he's actually at times did okay. He's lively, he's quick, he scored a few goals, and they get a bit of luck here, but not enough to get them the points.
This was on the hour. What are your observations, sort of day after day, there's a new bulletin of what might happen. What are your observations about what we're hearing and reading about the future development of the club?
Well, I think it's slightly more positive as each day goes by, because there's possible consortiums and possible money going to come into the club, and it's going to resolve the situation. But just because somebody's there to buy it doesn't mean it's all healthy. You've only got to look at the last person that bought it for a pound. What I would say, and I don't want to be too harsh, on the footballing side, he could only name five substitutes, Ali McCoys, yesterday. But I still think, and I don't want people to think this is harsh, I still think they should be getting better results on the field, because I think once you get on that football pitch, your 90 minutes, you forget about the problems and you concentrate on your football. Would that be a fair assessment? Or
I think that's, when I was a player, when I was at Celtic, we had the similar problems, buying takeovers, money problems, and I think the easy excuse sometimes for players is that's an excuse for their poor performance or poor results. So I think you've got to take that away from players. They're still going to their training. Of course, they've got problems taking wage cuts and all that. I never had that to deal with. But when you cross that white line, there's only one thing you're focusing on, is that in the performance. And at the moment, it's not good enough from Rangers, and they've got the big one next week, Celtic, coming to town.
The rest of the action from yesterday is on the way, as we build towards the kickoff in today's Hearts Hibs derby. It's the goals and the talking points in the Weatherwell Aberdeen match and the Sir Mirren St Johnston game.
Yes!
Well played!
Good job.
In the FA Cup with Budweiser, live here on ESPN, the Chelsea-Leicester FA Cup quarter-final kicks off just after 2 o'clock today. Atmosphere at the bridge and at football grounds everywhere will be somewhat muted, given the news that Fabrice Muamba is still in a critical condition in hospital after collapsing during yesterday's Bolton-Tottenham FA Cup quarter-final. One of those grounds is Tyne Castle, where Hearts and Hibs will play an SPL derby. Fans of both teams are gathering in readiness for a midday kickoff. Base camp for ESPN today is Stamford Bridge. The Chelsea-Leicester FA Cup quarter-final kicks off somewhat right off the back of the Hearts-Hibs derby. Plenty of time before kick-off. Let's go through yesterday's SPL games. And first of all, we have the perfect person to talk about Motherwell's game yesterday. Stephen Craven is on the commentary gantry at Tyne Castle, ready to bring us commentary on the Edinburgh derby. Okay, Stephen, we know you're out injured for a few weeks. Best wishes to get back soon. Take us through Motherwell's game yesterday, because there's so much for you guys to play for now.
Well, there is, especially knowing that Dundee United had beaten Rangers before we took the field, Ray. It was important for us to, you know, get a victory, get 3 points. And after the game, we found out St Johnstone had won at St Mirren. So, it became crucial for us. And it was probably an unlikely score for us. Stephen Hamill hasn't scored many goals over his long Motherwell career, but yesterday's was absolutely fantastic. There wasn't an awful lot between the teams. It was disappointing to lose the Scottish Cup tie to Aberdeen last week, so I wouldn't say revenge was in our minds, but I think a little bit of, probably a better performance and a better result. So thankfully for us, we got a 1-0 victory.
You've won 4 of the last 5. Are people starting to talk yet about a Champions League qualifier? Do you dare start thinking about that yet?
Well, I think we have to start thinking about it, Ray, to the extent of if we're now level on points with Rangers, if Rangers don't get their books in time by the 31st of March,
I think the third place could then become second, and we could make Champions League. So, I mean, it's an exciting time. I mean, for our club even to be challenging for top six, I thought was excellent. To be challenging for third or fourth place, and maybe even second now with what, eight games to go, you know, I think it's a realistic aim for us. You know, keep looking above us, keep picking up points. And next week, the big, you know, the big game at Fir Park and is, you know, whenever Rangers come to town, if we can pick up 3 points, then, you know, it could put it in our favour.
Stephen, thanks very much. All the best. Get fit soon.
Motherwell v Barcelona.
Well, I don't think Barcelona will play in the qualifiers somehow, but I take your point.
If they get through the qualifiers, yes, you know what I mean.
No.
It's going to be a long day today.
Yeah. It's always a long day when you're here, trust me. But the fact that Motherwell are doing so well now, you can't argue with their form. They're 4 out of 5 and moving forward.
I think Stuart McCall and his players deserve all the credit. They've had a fantastic season. Small budget, nothing to spend, small squad. And here they are on Rangers' tail for second place. And I think they've got to fancy themselves. Going into an important part of the season, fully confident. No pressure on Motherwell. All the pressure on Rangers. So I think they've got to be aiming for that second place.
Okay, let's take a look at the St Mirren St Johnston game yesterday. This is a terrific result for St Johnston.
Yeah, and Steve Lomas has gone in there and he's carried on the good work, really, of Derek McInnes. I mean, he'll want to stamp his own authority on it. We know money's tight, there's no doubt about it, but going away from home in any league and picking up a good victory and some good goals like that is a bonus for them. So, yeah, they're on a good run.
Without a doubt, keeper's got to do better here, unfortunately, for St Mirren's point of view. 2-0 down at home, but it's not an easy place to go and get a victory. St Mirren themselves playing good football, having a good season. They've got a cup replay to look forward to next week. So, 3-0 away from home. Sandaza, again, keep 12th goal of the season, keeps his composure and just pops it past the goalkeeper. But reiterate what Craig says, Steve Lomas came in. He's doing another outstanding job. Top six looks like no problem.
Fifth in the table after a couple of eighth place finishes. So there's another club making ground forward.
Yeah. I think that's the important thing for clubs, that you've just got to, you're always going to try and progress. It's not easy because we know, especially in the SPL, the budget is really, really tight. But all you can do is go in there, organise the players, train the players hard, go down the lower leagues in England or even the non-league, try and pick up a couple of little nuggets that you can bring up on the cheap.
Okay, 25 minutes to kick off in the Hearts-Hibs derby. The rivalry between the two teams is well documented. We all know what it's going to be like today. Over to Keith Downey, who's pitchside at Tynecastle.
Thanks very much, Ray. Yes, I'm joined by a man who, of course, was the assistant manager here at Tynecastle for so long. In the away dugout today, how does it feel to be back, Billy?
Well, it's certainly strange, and I never thought I'd be here. You know, when we started the season here, we, you know, had great hopes, Jim and I, challenging for the league, but here, you know, we're vying for relegation at the moment, which isn't great. But, you know, every concentration I've got will be in today's game, and a victory for Hibs is all that counts.
Did you have to think twice as to which dressing room you walked into when you arrived?
Yeah, well, it is a wee bit different, you know, and you know, I had a lot of good memories here, a lot of good times here. But that's football, and it just shows you anything can happen in football.
And you're a spy in the camp, I suppose. You know both sets of players better than anyone else.
Well, I'll just count up. I think in our time here, I think it was just under 2 years, Jim and I signed about six of these lads, you know, so I do know them. They're competitive. You know, I thought, you know, we would have done better with them, but it wasn't it to be. And, you know, went to Hibs, and the team's a lot better at Easter Road now. So, you know, I'm quite confident things will go better today.
I'm glad to get you while you're still calm. Good luck today. Thanks,
I'm
Billy.
Always calm.
So you say. Thank you.
He may well be jumping out of his chair, whatever happens today. One team goes forward, he'll be out of his chair. Other team, maybe. Yeah. Well done, Billy Brown. OK, there's the formation the Hibs are going to go with today. What are your observations, John?
I think the strengths, the two forward players, O'Donovan and Griffiths, both of them have got decent pace. Griffiths is scoring goals. Lively, very busy player. Sometimes, for me, he drifts a little bit wide too much and runs with the ball, but he's a pest in and around the box. O'Donovan, new to the club, got his goal last week, so that should give him confidence. Again, he's got pace, so strikers, what do they need? They need service, so they're going to have to get it off the midfield.
They look a bit weak to me in midfield, I would say, with Stevenson in there. But Lee Griffiths is he's a player. I was talking to my old Scotland colleague, Billy Dodds, about him. Dodds had him at Dundee when Dodds was coaching up there, and he said he is a really, really talented individual. He earned himself a move to Wolves, where it hasn't really worked out for him. and a Wolves squad that has been struggling. That may reappear for him, that may come again. But he's got a chance to be here on loan, hasn't he, and play week in, week out, which he wasn't getting at Wolves because he's in the reserves.
Big Hibs fan, so this will be a massive game for him. And the important thing is he keeps his composure. Sometimes when you're a supporter of the club, you get carried away and you do silly things. He's got to make sure he keeps his head nice and calm, doesn't get involved in anything silly, and concentrates on playing football.
They have an on-loan captain in James McFaig. What sort of impact can he have on the game?
Well, the problem they've had, they've conceded soft goals. They've never really had a leader at the back. So he's 27-year-old. He's on loan from Coventry. And obviously the manager's seen straight away something in the dressing room and on the park. He's a talker. He's made him captain, which is really unusual. But he's got experience. So big job for him, talking to the players round about him.
John, Craig, in situations like this, you want your players to be incredibly competitive, of course, but also you want them to be in control of their emotions to get the best out of themselves. How do you balance that as a manager giving out signals and then when you were a player trying to get the best out yourself?
Well, as a manager, first you've got to be competitive. You've got to want to win the 50-50s, but the danger in these type of games is they get carried away and they're over-aggressive and get silly booking the red cards. So it's a fine line between having aggression, but it's got to be controlled.
It's just down to the players, isn't it? Once they're out here on the football field, it's their decisions. Mm. And the better players make the better decisions. It's controlled aggression. Yep. And they have to be today. There's no doubt it's going to be a great atmosphere because Tynecastle's always an excellent place to play for me. This Heart side are a lot stronger. Hibs are going to be up against it, no doubt about it.
Pre-match thoughts from both managers are on the way. Both really need their team to perform today. Kickoff at Tynecastle is at midday. Hoping for a Hearts win will be Ian Black Jr. and Ian Black Sr. Dad played for Hearts in the late 70s. Some will be right in the thick of things for the Jambos today.
I haven't lost a derby, touch wood, so in 3 years, so hopefully I can keep that going. But the derby's great. It's one of the games that you look forward to every season.
The atmosphere is building at Tynecastle, where Hearts and Hibs will meet for the third time this season in the SPL. Hearts have won the last two. In fact, they haven't lost in 9 Edinburgh derbies. And with Hibs fighting to avoid relegation, they need to win. Let's rejoin Keith Downey.
Ray, well, one of the biggest supporters inside Tynecastle today, will play centre midfield for Hearts. Ian Black grew up here at Tynecastle as a ball boy before following in the footsteps of his father and pulling on the maroon jersey for Real. Martin Keegan has been catching up with Ian Black, junior and senior, this week.
Guys, you both spent plenty of time in this dressing room. Ian Senior, first of all, what are your memories of being around this club?
The manager at the time was Willie Ormond. Teammates were Jim Jeffries, Drew Busby, Willie Gibson, all old-timers compared to me then, because I was just a young lad then.
It almost puts a smile on my face when people are commenting on how good a player my dad was, and obviously I'm catching up with being a good player as he was.
Do you talk much after a game? If you come to watch Ian play, do you phone him up and let him know how he played?
Be honest, I actually stand outside waiting on him until he comes out. And I would discuss it, and I'm probably his biggest critic because I tell him the truth.
Sometimes I wouldn't mind avoiding the call, but no, it's good to get feedback from other people, not just obviously the gaffer, and it helps to get the bad sides, but it is always nice to get the good bits.
You do get a lot of press attention, if you like, for the way that you play or the way that you're seen to play. Do you think it's a fair reputation that you have?
Nah, I wouldn't say it's fair. If you look at other players in the SPL's records and discipline, I'm certainly not up there. Not naming any names, but I wouldn't class myself as a dirty player and a bad player. But if you're branded that, then you've got to just take it on the chin and get on with it.
It's probably like myself, when you walk over a white line, you want to win at all costs. Compared to when I played now, some of the players wouldn't get a game when we played because it was that physical, but nowadays they all want to fall about and it's different altogether.
What are your memories of playing in the Edinburgh Derby?
Not very good, actually, because obviously I only played 3 derbies and we lost 2 and drew 1, so it doesn't go down too well. On that sense, but No, the local derby, it's a big game for Edinburgh and the two clubs itself, and obviously there's a lot of passion in it.
Honestly, throwing my record, I've not lost a derby, touch wood, so in 3 years, so hopefully I can keep that going. But the derby's great, it's one of the games that you look forward to every season. It's just the buzz around the place, and just like the atmosphere as soon as you walk out the tunnel, just for the warm-up alone.
You got a bit of stick, obviously, for, you know, the celebration and the T-shirt and everything else. Is it something you look back on and regret, or is it something you just say, you know, you have a laugh about it?
I never regret anything. You know, it's partner, football partner, and partner every day in the world. And like I say, I just showed a wee bit of a T-shirt, and the Hibs fans, obviously, they rub it in a wee bit, but no, it's friendly banter, I certainly didn't regret it.
You know, unless you're beating the Scottish Cup final, the Edinburgh Derby this weekend is likely to be the last clash of the season. How much are you looking forward to it, and what would that win mean to you?
Winning the Derby would mean almost to the world, because it's the last Derby this season. You always want to finish on a high in the Derbies. Obviously, they're struggling at the moment, and just to go out there, and you never want to lose a Derby. It's always a buzz when you're walking about Edinburgh and you've won a Derby, and there's a lot of Hibbies around my area though, so it's always nice to walk back in and kind of smile at them if you get a win.
Okay, what would your scouting report be on Ian Black? We've got John Collins and Craig Burley warming up for the Hearts Hibs Derby.
I think he's a big player for Hearts. He's a real competitor, always snapping at the tackle. Sometimes he can be a little bit dubious with his tackling, but when he wins the ball, he uses it well as well. So I think the Hibs players have got to make sure they don't get involved with him, because he likes to get involved in the tackling and messing the opposition about. We've got to stay composed against him.
Is that going back to what you were saying before? We were discussing this before. As a manager, of course you want to keep your players level-headed. As a player, sometimes you can't get carried away, and Ian can't get carried away.
Well, he can, and I think he admitted that himself, but I think I'd describe him as really tidy, gets the odd goal, but needs to really keep himself on the pitch. I think if you're looking at him, you think, you need to keep yourself on the pitch if you're a manager, because he's not good to anybody when he's off it.
Who's going to score the goals today for Hearts?
Scatchell, well, he's a top scorer. I think Beattie's come in, signed from Swansea. I think he played very well last week. He hasn't had a lot of playing time down south. He's up, he knows the Scottish League inside out. A number of years at Celtic, scored goals for them. I think he'll be a threat, he'll be live, he'll be desperate to get on the score sheet as well. But I think he's one of those players, he's been stuck in the bench or in stand for a year or so, so he'll have that passion, that desire to get about the pitch. He's very mobile, he likes to take the ball at the chest, he's a bit of a target man, but at the same time, he's got decent pace about him.
Yeah, I mean, I think it was a surprise when Jim Jeffries brought Scatchell back, but, you know, I think bringing Beattie in on loan is a good move for them. He's not worked out for him in England, at both West Brom, really, and Swansea. And again, he's at an age of 28, he needs to play.
We're at Stamford Bridge today, base camp for ESPN, because right on the back of the Hibs Hearts Derby, we're going to be having the Chelsea-Leicester FA Cup quarter-final. OK, let's hear from both managers now ahead of the derby in Edinburgh. Let's see what they have to say.
Paulo, Hearts are 9 matches unbeaten in the Edinburgh Derby. What's the secret to the success in these matches?
First of all, that is past, that is don't have any influence in the game of today. But I'm sure that to get all these good results, every game was hard, and in every game the team was to be very focused in what they should do in the pitch. So today is not going to be different.
The club released a statement this week saying the players won't be paid on time. They weren't paid on time on Friday. Do you worry that that might affect their performance?
I believe it's not the moment to be talking about that. I want to be focused on the game and speaking about football. It's for that I came here to talk with you about football, not about those problems. It's not the moment to speak about that.
Well, you've chosen a very attack-minded side today. You're obviously going to go at Hibs.
I believe every time when I choose the lineup is to try to win. I believe this one today is the best I could choose. Because of that, they are the starting 11. We work in our idea to try to win this game, so I hope I'm helping the players to do it.
Thanks, Paulo. Good luck.
Thank you.
Pat, 6 Edinburgh Derby debutants in your starting lineup today. What do you say to these guys before the match?
I think you just go and enjoy it. It's a great occasion. Go and play. There's no baggage with these players from previous ones, so it's a matter of going out and expressing yourself and enjoying the game and the occasion.
Are you beginning to see an improvement? You brought so many players in January. Are they beginning to click now?
Yeah, I think we've been on a half-decent run, to be honest. The results have been OK, out with probably the Celtic game, and you know the players have performed quite well in that, and we've got to continue that today. It's still a lot of big games for us between now and the end of the season, so we've got to make sure we maintain that level of consistency if we can.
The Hearts players haven't been paid on time. They rallied round and performed really well the last time that happened. Is that a concern for you?
No, it doesn't concern me. It's none of my business, to be honest. So whatever they want to do here is their own business, I suppose.
Got Billy Brown in the camp, a spy in the camp. He knows both sets of players better than any other. Will that help you today?
Well, it's given us a better insight into the Hearts players, definitely, and how they may perform. So, but on the day, it's about players' attitudes and how they perform themselves. And our own players have got to stand up to be counted today. We haven't done that enough times when Hibs have come here, and it's about time we change that.
Thanks, Pat. Cheers.
Thank you.
Thank
Cheers.
You. Thanks a lot.
Thanks, Pat. Appreciate it.
A statement has been released from Bolton Wanderers Football Club. Fabrice Muamba remains in a critical condition in intensive care in the heart attack centre at the London Chest Hospital. Fabrice was admitted to the hospital yesterday evening after collapsing at White Hart Lane, where he sustained a cardiac arrest during the FA Cup quarter-final against Tottenham Hotspur. Fabrice received prolonged resuscitation at the ground and en route to the London Chest Hospital, where his heart eventually started working. As his normal medical practice, Fabrice remains anaesthetised in intensive care and will be for at least 24 hours. His condition continues to be closely monitored by the cardiac specialist at the hospital. Bolton Wanderers manager Owen Coyle has received a statement too. Fabrice's family have asked me to pass on their thanks for the many, many kind messages of support, not only from the Bolton fans, but also from football fans across the country and abroad. All our thoughts and prayers are with Fabrice and his family. And the family would also like to thank the media for respecting their privacy at this time. We echo everything that Owen Coyle has been saying. No further updates are planned at this time. Okay, very close to kick-off now in the Hearts-Hibs derby at Tynecastle. Not out of the question that these two sets of fans won't gather at Hampden for a Scottish Cup final. That's possibly for another day, but precious SPL points on the table today. It's Hearts versus Hibs live here on ESPN. Arthur's Seat is populated in Edinburgh. And Tynecastle is quickly filling up. Here we go, Hearts versus Hibs, live here on ESPN, a third derby victory of the season. Top four finish, win the cup, that's the target for Hearts. Win the cup, stay up, and a first derby win in 10 attempts is the target for a Hibs side fighting to avoid relegation. Ready to guide us to the game, it's Motherwell defender Stephen Craigan alongside Derek Ray.
Thank you very much, Ray. Morning, everyone. A fixture first played 137 years ago. Hearts against Hibs remains a Scottish football occasion to savour. Two proud Edinburgh clubs with different histories, yes, but one shared narrative. And whenever maroon and white meets green and white, we are reminded of the epic capital derbies of the past and look forward, we hope, to another one to enter into the canon. There's no getting away from it. Part of Midlothian, Kewl Hibernian and vice versa. You might say in the Edinburgh tradition that they go together like salt and sauce. Edinburgh chip shop aficionados know what I'm talking about. Hearts are shorn of the suspended Marius Zaniukas and the injured Adrian Mroviets, while Ryan McGowan drops to the bench. In have come Darren Barr, who celebrated his 27th birthday yesterday. Jamie Hamill, he returns from suspension. And Rudy Scatchell, so often a derby hero. Scatchell makes his 100th appearance for the Jambos.
Darren Barr hasn't played a lot of football this season, along with Andy Webster. He'll have his hands full with the movement and mobility of Hibs front two, Griffiths and O'Donnell. And their front five look as if plenty of creativity amongst them. And I think the arrival, Derek, of Craig Beattie has given them a physical presence in an important area of the pitch.
Hibs make two changes from the team that beat Ayr United 2-0 in last week's cup quarter-final. Both enforced. Isaiah Osborne and Ivan Sproul are suspended. In have come David Wotherspoon and a fit again Tom Soares on loan from Stoke City. Soares is one of six Edinburgh Derby debutants in the Hibernian side, Stephen.
Yeah, Pat Fennan's been saying all week, Derek, that it won't be a Derby walk in the park this time for Hearts. So these players he's picked today will have to deliver on their manager's promise. There's an opportunity for Hibs to go 7 7 points clear of Dunfermline with only 8 games to go. James McPeak at centre-half has been a crucial signing, but up front, Lee Griffiths, if he keeps his composure, stays on the pitch, he could be a potential match winner.
Finland, a serial achiever in the Republic of Ireland, must be hoping St Patrick's timekeeping is a little bit off this year. Luck can often play its part in this fixture. Craig Beattie has made an explosive start to his Hearts career. He scored and had a goal controversially disallowed in his first start against St Mirren in the Cup. When you hail from Leeds, this game takes on added significance. It means an awful lot to Hibs striker Lee Griffiths. And Sergio planning to make it a hat-trick of Derby wins this season. 2 out of 2 against Hibs so far. Scotland's Euro 2012 referee is in charge today, Craig Thompson. And away we go. Edinburgh's day in the spotlight. It is the 260th league meeting of Hearts and Hibernian. Will the home side be feasting on cabbage and ribs? Or is it Hibs' turn to gore Jim Corgi on a few jam tarts? Stephen, it's always appetising.
It is, Derek. Derby games, no matter whereabouts you're playing the world, are always fiery affairs. There's always plenty of tackles. The tempo of the game seems to be much higher than a normal game. So I think it's vital for the new Hibs players, especially, to try and settle in, get used to the tempo, and try and have an influence in the game.
Andy Webster, in the middle of the Hearts defence. Hearts playing towards the Roseburn end of the ground, not too strong for Stephen Elliott. Andy Webster in his second spell with the Jambos. Scored in the two previous derbies this term. Not really going to put your money on that.
No, you wouldn't have, but I think that's what it's going to take today. You know, it's going to take a team effort. You're going to have everybody chipping in, making an influence in the game. And in these games especially, Derek, the first goal, for me, is always vital. Hibs struggling this season so far, the first goal for them could be crucial.
That's unbeaten now in 9 derbies. A run stretching back to May of 2009. In current form, you can make a compelling case for Hibernian. Victorious in the last 2 competitive away games. Rudy Scatchell, the favourite of the Hearts supporters. The Granger couldn't quite get there. Might be a chance here. The whistle is gone. And David Wotherspoon trying to finish off the move.
A big call from Craig Thompson so early in the game. Tom Soares on the right-hand side. Great header back across the box. That's a great ball from Graham Stack. Great header. I think the foul is for, I think Lee Griffiths just nudges Andy Webster out of the way. And such an early, crucial decision in the game from Craig Thompson. He's been criticised recently, Derek, for some decisions he's made. But, you know, time will only tell. Was that another one?
It's always a very difficult match for a referee, this. Andy and eyes in the back of the head job. Granger in position to take the throw. In successive start for Granger, former St Johnston man. Webster, and back to Jamie McDonald. Recently extended his deal with Hearts, tying him to the club until 2014. Ian Kellow appears to be frozen out for good. He refused to leave the club in January. So he was bound for Austria, Vienna, didn't work out that way. Stephen Elliott. Matty Towill with the effective little touch on. Jamie Hamill. Hamill and Towill, the two former Kilmarnock players together. The ball did stay in. Here is Elliott. And the block by Paul Hanlon. Scotland under 21 international. Defensive linchpin for Hibernian.
Just get a sense, Derek, both sets of players are really up for the game. You know, both sets of fans, every tackle, every touch, they're cheering. You know, they're looking for someone on their side to give them an influence and a good start in the game.
Andrew Driver has gone over there to the right. It'll be Hamill with the throw for Hearts. Beattie's speculative ball, Scatchell. Hibs looking a bit hesitant. A clash of heads there. Frankham's on the ground, so too Sketchell.
I think it all comes from here. You know, Graeme Stack can alert this. If he just shouts to James McPake, I think he can let it go. But I think Sketchell had to go for the ball. Frankham had to go for the ball. Both wanted to win it. And I think, Derek, that looks like a nasty clash of heads. You can see Rudy Sketchell still lying on the ground, a little bit uneasy. And I fear that one of them could be at least going off for a few stitches.
Well, it doesn't look good at all, does it, for Rudy Sketchell? He's going to have to be patched up. A struggle for Sketchell to keep that eye open. George Frankham, fifth successive start for the defender on loan from Norwich. That's the sort of thing you expect in an Edinburgh derby. And Sergio tends to favour the patient approach. It often goes out the window in these games.
Yeah, well, I think you can see by his lineup, with having Andy Driver and Mary Taul and Rudy Sketchell, Stephen Elliott, you know, he likes ball players. He wants to pass the ball, but I think the addition of Craig Beattie has, you know, will in the long term be a good foil for these players, because he carries a physical presence, he can win headers, he can take them up the pitch. So I think he's got a good balance.
Well, Sketchell and Franken off the pitch receiving treatment. Ian Black. Beattie to control it. Good for handball. Craig Thompson wasn't interested. Away goes Lee Griffiths. So over there to cover. He was essentially on his own that time, Griffiths. Sketchell on the road to recovery. Frankham is still being attended to. Sketchell is now back with us. So Hearts for the time being with the numerical advantage. Will be a free kick after all that. There's Stevenson, a 24-year-old midfield player. First joined Hibs at the age of 14. Not sure what they use on the back of the head there. Make sure everything is sealed up, Stephen.
Yeah, I think it's a little bit of glue. It'll probably just time over to half-time. I would think if he needs stitches, Derek, you know, it'll take maybe 10 minutes. So they want to get him back on the pitch, get him patched up, get him to half-time. There's still a long way to go, but get him to half-time and then get him sorted properly.
Webster trying to shepherd it back to McDonald. And Griffiths was looking things interesting.
That's the kind of tenacity that the Hibs fans love from Lee Griffiths. You know, a ball he probably has no right to go for. You know, there's no foul in the goalkeeper, he jumps clearly. Suddenly he's earned his team a corner kick.
David Wotherspoon tasked with taking the Hibernian corner. Pulls nicely for Beattie. Scope now for Hearts to get forward. Craig Beattie has made a name for himself as a Celtic player. And Craig Thompson is going to produce the yellow card here. Tom Soares called over. Soares on loan from Stoke City.
Well, I think it's hard to try and defend him in this situation. You know, he's had a little pop at him once. He's had a little tug at him. Craig Beattie, you know, taking his team up the pitch. He's hit him there. He's caught him again, and eventually he catches him just before the halfway line. So an early booking for Tom Soares. He's going to have to be careful now in the rest of the game. He's going to have to time his tackles. You know, he can't leave his leg hanging in and do something silly and put his team down to 10 men. Got to be careful.
It's going to be a substitution for Hibernian. George Frankham won't be able to carry on. Doherty will be the replacement. Hamill. Secure touch by Beattie. Away by Pa Kujabi, the Gambian left back for Hibernian. And they are unable to stop the bleeding. Hence this change now. It's a sad end to this derby for George Frankham. his first appearance in the Edinburgh Derby, and it's a similar story for Matt Doherty. A man from Dublin, on loan from Wolves. But he'll be able to slot into right back, Stephen.
Well, I think, you know, young George Franken will remember his first Edinburgh Derby for all the wrong reasons, Derek, you know, leaving the ground, likely with stitches. But Matt Doherty has played there before. He's played centre-half since Pat Fenning came in as well, so he's an ideal replacement.
Scatchell for Heart of Midlothian. Sent it away by James McPake. And the captain of Hibernian. A club captain, of course, Ian Murray still has that honour, but Ian Murray out injured has been for a while.
The game really hasn't settled, has it? You know, Hearts initially had a couple of passes, but, you know, no one's really put their foot in the ball. I think early on, you know, either team are just helping the ball on and trying to ask questions of the opposition.
Doherty's throw. Soares. Claros wanted it played to him. Claros, the Honduran. Soares disguised it well. Doherty. And away by Towell. Jabby is keeping a weather eye on Elliott. Claros, free kick, Towell, the offender. Thompson wants a quiet word with Mehdi Towell.
I think it's a big day for the ref, you know, he has to, you know, especially in a derby game, composure, Derek, he has to try and control the players. I think he has to speak to them in a controlled manner because, you know, emotions are running high in such a big game.
Soares, to beat Granger in the air, Ian Black, supporting Hearts. So Hearts, ball boy, in his younger days, as his dad played for the club as well. Soares, Tavis flying in. You don't really get much of a chance to breathe in the Edinburgh Derby. It goes with the territory. Johnson thought about that for a second or two. Free kick in favour of Craig Beattie at Hearts.
It's an opportunity now for Darren Barr and for Andy Webster just to make their way. And I just wonder, is it a little bit far out? You know, the angle's not really favouring the Hearts players for a shot at goal, so I wouldn't be surprised if it stood up and maybe Andy Webster could get his third goal of the season in an Edinburgh Derby.
Graham Stack, the Hibernian goalkeeper. Hibs the eighth club of his British football career. Ian Black and Danny Granger together. Is the right foot of Black. Oh, that could have gone anywhere. It's a good deflection behind for the corner.
It's an excellent hit free kick. I think what he's doing is he's kind of shooting, but he's also trying to put it into an area that if it takes a deflection, Derek, sometimes it can go on target. Graham Stack was just standing still. If it was on target, it was 1-0, but good pressure again from Hutch.
Left footed Danny Granger to take the corner. Crowded penalty area scene. Of Roy O'Donovan. So many of the players in Hibs ranks on loan from other clubs. That was the Pat Fenland strategy in January. Bringing as many credible new faces as possible, in most cases on a loan basis. Granger with it. Good long throw. No problems in the end for Stack.
No, and I think now Hibs are going to have to start to trying to get themselves into a game in an attacking sense. Derek, I think they've defended reasonably well so far, but, you know, I spoke beforehand about O'Donovan and about Griffiths, but they really haven't had the service to them. And I think if they're going to do well today and Hibs are to get a positive result, these two guys are going to have to be involved, whether it's balls in the feet or balls in the channels for them to chase.
O'Donovan, you might remember him from his time with Dundee United a few years ago, on loan then from Sunderland, on loan now at Hibs from Coventry. Man from Cork, Got a wonder goal against Kilmarnock recently. James McPick from the back for Hibs. It's Tawil. Be quite the artist with the ball at his feet, Mehdi Tawil. The best of touches though from Stephen Elliott. Mehdi Tawil, Jim Jeffries signing of course. They'd worked together at Kilmarnock. Elliott. BT. And down he goes. It was BT up against Hanlon.
I think the fans aren't too happy, but you know, I think it's a ball that Paul Hanlon has to go for. Is there a little nudge in the back? Well, there certainly isn't contact in the back of the head, so Craig Beattie's just got to be a little bit careful what he's doing, but I think Paul Hanlon has every right to go for that ball.
Paul Hanlon, Edinburgh-born. Product of Richardson Vale Boys Club. So many terrific Edinburgh footballers have come through that system over the years. Source by Darren Barr to Jamie McDonald.
The problem with Hibs, Derek, for me is that, you know, with Griffiths and O'Donovan up front being, you know, slightly smaller than most normal centre forwards, any high ball is suiting Darren Barr and is suiting Andy Webster. So I think they've got the upper hand so far, and Tancastle's quite a tight pitch and it's hard to get the ball in behind. So far I think the Hearts centre halves have been dominant and very comfortable.
So Webster has to be quick. Shoots for McDonald. It's a tight pitch here at Tancastle, but it's a great amphitheatre. One man who knows this ground very well is Jim Jeffries, who's in attendance today. The former Hearts manager, two spells at the helm, being linked with the vacancy at Dunfermline. Does Hibs require a win today to move seven clear of the bottom club, Dunfermline?
I'm surprised he's here. If rumours are to be believed, I thought he was having talks with Dunfermline today, Derek, so it must be after the game maybe, but yeah, he's certainly been linked with a return.
Dunfermline parting company with Jim McIntyre the other day. Work by Scatchell, here is Driver for Beattie. Wasn't quite right for him.
That was excellent play all round, wasn't it? You know, it's really the first time that they've got wide and got a ball into the box, and that's the man they're looking for, is Craig Beattie. I always felt that when it was just Stephen Elliott in his own, Derek, Hearts were very one-dimensional, but I think by adding Craig Beattie to their side, it gives them something different. When they're struggling, they can throw the ball into the box and go a little bit more direct up top, and he can challenge, and Stephen Elliott and Andy Driver and Rudy Scatchell can gamble and try and link up with him.
Goes Darren Barr, former Falkirk defender. And there's Stevenson trying to help the ball on its way. Griffiths was over there. Beattie was back there as the extra defender. Javi's throw for Hibs. Away by Hamill. An awkward son. It's a perfect afternoon for football here in the capital. That's with the edge in terms of possession so far, 60% to Hibs 40.
I think that's probably right, Derek, isn't it? You know, without really looking threatening, apart from the in black free kick, you know, most of the play has been through Hearts. Any kind of Hibs play has been in the middle of the pitch. They haven't really had anything in the final third.
Soares with Granger. Maros will be a hard throw. Ian Black, I suspect, don't you, if you were to cut him open, he might just bleed maroon. Ian Black, Hearts to the core.
He just loves these occasions, and I think he hasn't lost an Edinburgh Derby yet, Derek, so he'll be thinking Edinburgh Derbies are great. You know, he's played in every one and he's unbeaten, so, you know, he's been very, very good.
Joined their club in 2009. Haven't lost any of the derbies since the start of that season. And free kick, Stephen Elliott, McDonald towards Greg Thompson. And the position again is promising.
And again, it's the link-up play. It's Craig Beattie and Stephen Elliott. You know, they're getting round about each other. They're playing closer together than what the Hibs front two are. They're asking questions of the Hibs back four. And again, they've gained themselves a free kick. I think this is a better angle now for Ian Black and for Danny Granger to, you know, to have a direct shot and goal and ask questions of Graham Stack and the Hibs goal.
Graham Stack just getting the wall organised. Empty towel. Ian Black, Danny Granger, one of the three Hearts suspects. A very inviting angle for the right-footed Black. And it is taken by Ian Black, and it's another deflection.
Well, the wall's done its job. That's the reason why Graham Stack puts him there. The Hibs wall don't jump. Some walls you see jump. I think it's James McPake just guides the ball over. But again, a little bit of sustained pressure.
Hutch. Swinger from Granger. Oh, and Stack claws it away. Webster foiled. Andy Webster, who scored in the two previous derbies this term. Here is Beattie. And out comes another corner to Hearts of Midlothian.
And I think that's the closest Hearts have came to scoring. It's Andy Webster. Just gets away from Paul Hannon. Gets across his man. Gets his header on target. It's a good save by Graham Stack, but Hearts are now really starting to up the ante, Derek, and really starting to look impressive.
20 minutes on the stopwatch. Taken again by Granger. And Webster was storming in, just couldn't make contact with the ball. These are encouraging moments for Hearts. Hip supporters in the Roseburn stand, 1,874 of them, I'm told. 1874, the year of Hearts formation.
And Derek, you know, it's not just been long-suffering with regards to derbies, but I think the last few seasons, their form hasn't been good, their league position hasn't been great, so credit to the Hibs fans for again coming in huge numbers to support their team. I think it's now time for the players to repair a little bit of faith in them and give them something to shout for. Maybe a derby victory would just appease them for a little while at least.
Well, certainly it's long overdue. No scoring, 21 minutes gone. And Claros, a bit too ambitious. Driver. And BC down it for the first time.
Craig B must have annoyed a few players in the tunnel, Derek, because every time he goes for the ball, this time it's Lewis Stevenson, Paul Hannon's had a little go at him, James McPake's had a little kick at him, so, you know, I think it shows what a vital player he can be for Hearts, Craig B, but Lewis Stevenson giving away a free kick. I suppose in a good area, you know, it's deep in the Hearts half, so Hibs can regroup.
Next, we'll let Barr do the honours. Dylan Barr returned 27 yesterday. Looking for Beattie. There's Kajabi. Didn't have a club on him side him. Most recently playing in the German second division for FSV Frankfurt. It was 18 months or so ago now. He's found a home in Leith. Tawil. Another spoon going to ground. Free kick.
It's really been the story of the game, hasn't it? You know, free kicks, niggly free kicks. You know, the game always being stopped and nobody really gaining momentum or fluency in the game. So, you know, but I suppose that's what you expect from a derby, Derek. It's plenty of tackles and plenty of fouls.
Hamlin looking for Soares. Claros. He's on loan from the Motagua club. Honduras. Izaguirre's former club. There's Granger, and he thought it was on. Nobody over there for the Jambos.
I must admit it was a strange choice of pass because there didn't seem to be anybody in that area whatsoever, and I think the Hearts fans have vented their frustration because they could have kept simple possession, but strange cross-field pass from Danny Granger.
Witherspoon was the meat of the sandwich that time. Tawil and Hamill, the two players arriving. Kajabi, Tariel. Now the combative Ian Black. Paul Hanlon. He's trying to get into the main stand. Member of the Hibs under 19 side that did the double in 2009. Under 19 league and the Scottish Youth Cup. That's one thing Hibs deserve tremendous credit for, the players they've brought through the ranks in recent years. Granger, and it came off Scatchell. Could have made life awkward for Stack at the Hibs goal.
I think the deflection on the ball takes a little bit of the pace off it. I think it's Tom Soares just edges forward. I think the deflection off him just takes the pace off it, makes it comfortable for Graeme Stack. But, you know, not a lot of goal mouth action in the last 5 or 6 minutes, Derek. And I think Hibs are going to have to put a little bit more into the game because I feel for me they're just waiting for Hutch to score.
True of Hibs in recent games here at Tynecastle. They have a tendency to play quite defensively. Keep things tight early on. The bookings very often are in evidence. Just the one so far. It's gone to Soares. One ball against Lee Griffiths here.
I think all the talk beforehand was, you know, what an influence he could have in the game. He's been in good form. He always asks questions of centre-halves with his movement and his ability, but really hasn't been in the game one little bit. And I'm sure Pat Fenham will be a little bit frustrated that they haven't got their talisman in the game. He hasn't really had an influence, and it's been a disappointing 25 minutes from him.
Prolific goal scorer Lee Griffiths at Livingston, then at Dundee. Hasn't done badly in his time with Hibs. 9 goals in 26 matches altogether. Griffiths for Kujabi. All that needed was a touch from Roy O'Donovan. Just couldn't get that touch on the ball. Fine run though from Kujabi, the left back.
It was excellent play from him. And he, you know, Kujabi's run makes this move happen. He could quite comfortably sit at left back, Derek, and not make a forward run. He puts the effort in. Unfortunately for him, it was Lee Griffiths that played him wide. I think Pat Fenham would have loved Lee Griffiths to be in the middle to tap that in, but at last Hibs look as if they're coming alive and wanting to take part in the derby.
Played 15 times for Gambia by Kujabi. Offside here against Stephen Elliott. Scored 2 goals in 4 previous Edinburgh derbies. Elliott, the man from Dublin.
I think if anyone's to be happy that Craig Beattie joined Hearts, Derek, it's probably Stephen Elliott. You know, he was always the focal point. Too small, having to fight with centre-halves, but Craig Beattie's took that pressure off him.
I say it is refreshing to see two strikers playing together. You don't always see it nowadays, and certainly Paolo Sergio, earlier this term, was sometimes loath to have two front men in tandem. Ian Black. This gives Hearts plenty of drive in the middle of the park. And what a ball that is! And great control by Beattie, who makes it look simple! Craig Beattie in his first Edinburgh derby! The goal, simplicity itself. Black the architect, and Beattie the lethal finisher.
It's just wonderful quality all round for Ian Black to see this pass and to actually make the pass happen. He's just onside, it shows it there. But what about the first touch, Derek? The goal is about Craig Beattie's first touch. If he miscontrols it, he doesn't get it. The pass, unbelievable. First touch, wonderful. Can he finish? Yes, he can. It's a wonderful goal for Hearts. And for me, a fully deserved 1-0 lead. Now Hibs have to come out and try and take part.
Well, there is know-how for you, courtesy of Craig Beattie. At the other end, it's Claros. His Hibs try to respond immediately. But Hearts have the lead. Beattie's goal.
It's excellent play, Derek. You know, this is the little Hibs chance, trying to get themselves back in. But at a time when you feel like you're dominating the game and you're carrying the most threat, that's the time you have to get your goal and make your mark in the game. And Hutch have certainly done that in wonderful style.
The Hearts have bossed this Edinburgh derby. over the last 3 years. Unbeaten in nine against the other half of the Edinburgh divide. And yet again in a derby, the High Bees are chasing the game. Webster, one of the obvious aerial targets for Danny Granger. Ahead of Webster, no problems for Graham Stack.
It's all about this man, isn't it, Craig Beattie? We spoke about the pass from Ian Black, but the touch, Derek, is sublime. That's what makes the goal. You know, he gets in behind. We spoke beforehand about the impact that he's had in his previous one and a half games for Hearts, and today again he showed what a shrewd sign it's been for Paulo Sergio. He's got the goal that is the difference between these two sides.
And it all happened in a blink of an eye. Black had the vision. Beattie had the ability in front of goal. Granger taking it quickly. Soares was on the ground just for a second or two. His driver. The Hibs can't afford to get rattled. Need to keep themselves in the game here. Roberto McDonald. Doherty was in the right back position for Hibernian. Claros. And they call the pit bull. Which will need a bit of aggression in the midfield area. They are to get back into this. It's the cross. Offside flag had gone up. Coming up on ESPN after we're finished. From Stamford Bridge, Chelsea against Leicester City in the FA Cup quarter-final with Budweiser. And looking forward to next weekend on ESPN, and the Barclays Premier League will be in the Potteries on Saturday from 4:30, Stoke City against Manchester City. Tawil for Hearts. Hanlon's header away. Jamie Hamill skews it. Taken by Witherspoon. That one drifted out. Witherspoon was looking for Griffiths.
Derek, it's strange watching the Hibs players. A lot of them don't look comfortable in this environment. You know, they don't look comfortable in the game. They're not getting involved, they're not taking touches, they're not completing their passes. Another one again, they're just kicking the ball away. They don't look as if they're comfortable, whereas the Hearts players are enjoying the atmosphere. They're taking part, they're playing passes, they're making things happen. So I think Pat Finn is going to have to try and get a message on these players that they're going to have to be a little bit more brave in the ball and take part.
Beattie. Is it against Kajabi? Oh, was looking for options. Decided to throw it back to Webster. Ian Black. Javi will be the recipient of the free kick.
Just wonder, even, you know, there's only 32 minutes gone, but will Pat Finlan already be thinking of making a substitution? I think he needs a physical presence up front, Derek. I don't think they've got an out ball whatsoever. It just keeps coming back, and maybe someone like Gary O'Connor might give them the physical threat to challenge Andy Webster and Darren Barr.
It's taken by Stark, it's headed away by Barr. Corner certainly an option on the bench for Pat Finlan. Kajabi need to find O'Donovan. It's commanding play at the back from Darren Barr. James McPeak. Hanlon. And it's disappointing.
It's just that, you know, from my point of view watching, it's just another aimless ball. There's Gary O'Connor, you know, probably one of the most frustrated Hibs substitutes there, because he knows he can make a difference. He can put Barr and put Webster under pressure, but at the minute, McPeak and Hanlon, it's just aimless balls forward, and, you know, I think it's very comfortable for the Hearts back four.
Hamill. Javi leaves it for Hanlon to deal with. The ubiquitous sea in black. Danny Granger was born just over the border. Penrith, northwest of England. McDonald gets rid of it. Up goes Beattie. And Driver. Decision goes against Andy Driver. Thompson, who will be Scotland's refereeing representative at the European Championship Finals in Poland and Ukraine later this year. It's Doherty. Forward by Hanlon. Scatchell. Oh, and Hanlon, looked a bit confused. Beattie having a swing at it.
Yeah, you know, he's certainly asking questions of the Hibs back four, and especially the two central defenders. Paul Hanlon gets himself a little bit caught under the ball, but you can understand why Craig Beattie is wanting to take a strike at that. He's full of confidence. I think he's epitomised everything with regards to Hearts, as far as I'm concerned, his work ethic, his determination, and he's the man that's got the goal.
Well, that's pretty decisive, isn't it? Seven attempts by Hearts, five of them on target. Not one from Hibs. Hanlon. So far, so good for Paolo Sergio. And Hart of Midlothian.
See him talking to Craig Beattie there. I'm wondering, you know, is he just saying to him, try and conserve some energy, save your energy, you know, you're winning tackles, you're winning headers, you're chasing back, you know, conserve your energy, and, you know, there's still, what, over an hour of this game left, so keep yourself, but he's been excellent for me.
And he stamped his authority on this derby in the first half, Craig Beattie.
Commentator's cursed a direct ball under his foot.
Never fails, Stephen. Webster. It's McPage. It's the most confident of touches. Made the move in January of 2009 from Livingston to Coventry. Back on loan from Coventry. Doherty. Go on this right-hand side. Barr had moved over to cover.
I think when you look at the game as a whole, and you know, the midfield battle is always key for me, Derek, in big games, and I don't think the Hibs midfield have really got the grips with the likes of Ian Black and with Rudy Scatchell and Andy Driver. I think they've had more of an influence on it. Hence the reason why the team are winning 1-0. So Pat's going to have to try and get his midfields, Claros and Stevenson, you know, they're going to have to get on the ball and try and make things happen a little bit more.
Ian Black, the man who set up the goal for Craig Beattie. Ian Black born here in the capital. Political Hart supporter as a boy. Soars, runs into Webster. Black. Trying to release Elliott this time. And up comes Stack. And a collision there. Graham Stack and Stephen Elliott.
Stephen Elliott looks in a little bit of trouble. You know, I don't know if there's a collision, but again, it's just a simple ball over the top. It's been more efficient for Hearts to ask questions of Hibs. And I think Stephen Elliott actually stumbles and just catches Graham Stack as he clears the ball, and Stephen Elliott's left hip, I think, is what's bothering him just now.
Both protagonists requiring treatment. And it gives us a chance, Stephen, to reflect on the opening 38 minutes. Frenetic, we expected that, and Hearts, the better side.
By a country mile, Derek, for me. You know, they're the ones that have looked most threatening. They've carried the most threat. They've looked the most composed on the ball and without the ball. They've kept their shape. They've been excellent. Hibs, unfortunately, have just carried on their form. I'm sure the Hibs fans will tell you that's been their form for many games this season. But they're going to have to try and turn it around. There's going to have to be a big turnaround at the half-time for Pat Fenwick, because it just hasn't been good enough. You know, they haven't competed all over the park enough. And I think if they could get the half-time at 1-0, I think Pat Fenwick would be happy. But, you know, Hearts with this pressure might be looking for a second.
Fenlon, who brought in 8 Hibs newcomers in the month of January. It was quite the clear out to bring in a higher quality of player. Elliott still limping noticeably after that collision with Stack. Griffiths, in goes Hamill, wholehearted competitor that he is. And Griffiths catches Tamil.
He's got to try and keep his frustration intact, Lee Griffiths, hasn't he, Derek? You know, we've seen him many occasions this season, him getting involved in other aspects of the game with supporters and with opposition players. He's just got to remain intact. You know, he's a little bit frustrated. He hasn't had the first half performance he'd have looked for, so he's just got to try and keep himself composed.
Not moving freely, Stephen Elliott. Beating has been everywhere. Towill. Scatchell looking for a driver. Granger comes off Soares. Oh, and Rudy Scatchell has taken here to be any contact at all. Certainly nothing significant. See what happened earlier in this derby. Clash of heads with Frankham, who had to go off, replaced by Doherty. Elliott. He has now collapsed in a heap, Stephen Elliott. Driver trying to win the corner and succeeded. I wonder if it's going to be the end of the story for Stephen Elliott.
You just think the way that he went down, he took a touch on the ball, he tried to lay it off and spin, and he just couldn't do it. I think his hip gave way, so I think we could see a substitution, if not at half-time, Derek, maybe before.
He's bravely making his way into the penalty area. Street at rush hour in that penalty area. Here's Black trying to create space. McPeak was back there. Important intervention by the Hibernian captain as Hamill nods it back to his goalkeeper, McDonald. Well, Elliott has hit the grass again. I can't imagine he's going to be able to continue the way this is going.
Yeah, Stephen Elliott has to go off. I think it's, you know, he's done well in the first half so far, along with Craig Beattie, but I think we can see that he's been struggling and can't make it.
Elliott. Frankham had to depart because of injury. Frankham, the Hibs defender, now it's the turn of the Hearts attacker, Stephen Elliott. Scott Robinson has been very quickly going through his paces. And that will be the change made by Heart of Midlothian. Scott Robinson, Edinburgh-born. Like Paul Hanlon, product of the Hutchison Vale Boys Club.
And replacing Stephen, welcome number 27, Scott Robinson.
And a sad sight. As Elliott makes his way off. It's interesting, Robinson began his career as a striker. In recent times has been used in a midfield role. This is always the option of pushing Scatchell into one of the forward positions.
Well, it seems to be now that Craig Beattie is maybe going to be a little bit more isolated, Derek, and you know, kind of consolidate the midfield. Maybe, you know, Paulo Sergio might just do that until half time, just to make sure they go in 1-0 up.
Ian Black who went down. And Roy O'Donovan for company. Difficult one to control. Claros towards Soares. No real rhythm from Hibernian in this first half. Granger for Hearts. Beattie competing for it with Hanlon. There's Robinson biting at the ankles of Wotherspoon. Wasn't of a mind to take any chances.
It's sensible play. I think the Hearts players will now be aware that half time's coming up. You know, they won't want to undo their hard work by giving something silly away.
Hibs wanting the corner. And it is given. We'll have a whopping 4 minutes of added time at the end of this first half. So the stoppages. Hanlon, McPake, the two central defenders have gone forward here. And it's not a bad corner. Griffiths trying to get on the end of it. Good delivery from Wotherspoon.
It is. It's an excellent ball in, but I think we can just see George Franken. Sorry, it's just free at the back post. And I just wonder who's supposed to be picking him up. Matt Doherty actually it was, and who's supposed to be picking up. So I think better organisation required from Hutch.
There's Kajabi. Left footer, the corner from the right, sails over everyone. That's not going to help the Hibernian cause.
And without being too critical of Kajabi, Derek, I think that just sums up Hibs' first half performance, isn't it? They've lacked that little bit of quality that's going to get them a goal. They've lacked a little bit of quality in their possession of the ball, their retention of the ball. And Hearts, for me, have been dominant.
Slight mishap, no real damage done. Clearance by McDonald. Hibs haven't had a clean sheet in the SPL in the calendar year of 2012. For the last clean sheet full stop in all competitions. Got to go back to the Scottish Cup meeting with Auchinleck Talbot. At the start of January, fourth round of the Cup.
I think unless Hibs improve, Derek, I think they'll be getting their first one here today. So. But I'm sure Pat Fenlon will realise that his players can't be as poor in the second half.
I'm sure the Hibs players will shortly have the words of Pat Fenlon ringing in their ears. McDonald fighting Webster. Plus one thing for a second or two. Comes off Hamill. Minimum of four added minutes promised at the end of this first half here at Tynecastle. Beattie. That'll be a Hearts throw. Beautiful Edinburgh day. Jabby doesn't much like the decision. Beattie on the receiving end. Jabby tries to get back quickly.
I feel as if Hutch will just take their time, set it up, you know, try and see the timeout. That'll give them a final attempt and goal, I think, before the half-time whistle, but they won't be rushing to put this ball into the box.
Something to cement a place in the top six. To put your money on them at this stage, the way things are going. Granger with it, Skinshaw! It will be a corner. Well, hang on. They've had a change of heart, the officials. And it will be a free kick, in fact. Came off Skinshaw last of all. Offside.
I think we can just see Andy Webster just edging across, but it's another great ball in from Danny Granger. Ian Black's put a few in as well, so dangerous set pieces.
Driver back to Granger. the slack by the usually reliable Ian Black. And the trend of recent Edinburgh derbies continuing on this Sunday afternoon here in Gorgie. Ian Black setting up the Hearts goal of record. It was finished off by Craig Beattie. And what a well-taken goal it was. Beattie in his first capital derby. Hibs have a lot of thinking to do. At the break, it is Hearts 1, Hibernian 0.
Well, Hearts' nine-game unbeaten run in derby matches hasn't looked under threat. And whether it's as a result of harsh words or whatever, Hibs fans will want to see much, much more from their team in the second half. Reaction from John Collins and Craig Burley coming up.
Well played. Squeeze.
Squeeze in there.
There you go.
Well done.
There you go. Spread out a bit.
Brilliant.
Spread out a bit.
These are dark days for one of football's biggest names. Now in a battle for second place, this season has been a nightmare for the Gers. And with the Steelmen eyeing the Champions League, could Motherwell split the old firm?
An emphatic finish!
Meanwhile, at the other end of the table, relegation strugglers Hibs face the Highlanders. Motherwell Rangers, part of a Scottish double coming up on ESPN.
Carling, sponsor of the Clydesdale Bank Premier League on ESPN.
The Barclays Premier League title race will be centre stage next Saturday here on ESPN. Tough game for Manchester City, who are striving to be champions for the first time in 44 years, because Stoke City have home advantage, and Stoke in with a chance of their highest top flight finish in 37 years. Pre-match coverage from 4:30. It's Hearts 1, Hibs 0, an SP Edinburgh derby underway at Tynecastle. Base camp for ESPN today is Stamford Bridge. The Chelsea-Leicester FA Cup quarter-final kicks off later today. John Collins and Craig Burley are watching the Hearts-Hibs game. And let's look at the goal that separates the team straight away. But all, one goal, could have been more. Hearts dominated this match.
Played very well, Hearts, in the first half. A wonderful goal here. It's all about Ian Black's inch-perfect pass. Lifts his head, plays it. Superb pass. Craig Beattie's first touch, terrific, sets him up nicely. Great goal from Hart's point of view. We're going to see poor defending from Hibs. Doherty there circled, he's going to be the other side. Beattie, and I think McPake in the middle, he's got to make a movement towards the right. He's got to see that space there and come a little bit across here, but he doesn't, he stays central, and that's an inch-perfect pass. No offside, McPake's hand goes up as usual, calling for offside. But
he's got to see, John, that Doherty, the substitute, is not going to get himself back in. He must see as a centre-half that the right-back's in a bad position, and he has to assess that situation and get himself over. And saying that, we talked about Black before the game, what he brings to the side, the tackling, the aggression. That's also a side that John mentioned before. He is tidy, he can't pass the ball. The touch from Beattie was kind of touches that got him his move from Celtic down to the Premier League to the likes of West Bromwich Albion, and he's rolled back a few years there, Craig Beattie.
What do Hibs need to do in this game? They're really not started. Sort of.
No,
is there a Sunday morning lie-in for them sometimes?
I don't think there's one player in the Hibs team can be happy with their first 45 performance. The forwards have been starved of service. We said that before the game. They need quality passes. Midfield haven't got any possession of the ball. I think on a few occasions the back four have headed it straight back up the park. When there's a little bit of time, they can take it on their chest. I'd like to see a little bit more composure from Hibs and try and get a hold of the ball, retain possession, and try and get it to the forwards.
They look like a side that are where they are, and that's second bottom of the league. I mean, Pat Fenlon has got a massive job in his hands here at Hibs. They've built this new stand. The stadium looks great, but there's no money to bring in any players. There's no budget. And this side is almost unrecognisable to me, apart from one or two players.
Two wins in the last 17 SPL games. Hear what you say, that they're not doing well. This is a derby. If there's one game you need to pick yourself up for and raise your game, it's this one.
You've either got the quality or you haven't. And on that first 45 minutes, they haven't got the quality. There's nobody in midfield can put their foot on the ball and say, I'm going to dictate this game from a Hibs point of view.
I think the positive from Hibs point of view, they're only one goal down. Mm. They haven't played at all. Hearts have dominated the first half, but one goal, often it's never enough.
Who knows what'll happen in the Hibs dressing room at half-time. Let's see if results in anything. Second half on the way. And this is a typical derby. There's passion, there's commitment. But the goal has been scored by Hearts. And Hibs really need to do something about it.
We'll be right back.
later this afternoon here on ESPN in the FA Cup with Budweiser. Chelsea and Leicester will play for a place in the semi-finals. Kick-off at Stamford Bridge, 2 o'clock. In the Clydesdale Bank SPL, second half of the latest Hearts-Hibs derby is about to get going. Hearts 1, Hibs 0, half-time score. Hibs haven't won in 49 games when they've been losing at half-time. Huddenby, they haven't lost. Hearts haven't lost in 9 derby matches. Hibs really need to do something in this second 45 minutes. Middle of defender Stephen Craigens alongside Derek Ray on the Tynecastle commentary gantry.
Many thanks again, Ray. Welcome back to Gorgie. And it will be Hibs to kick off the second half, attacking the goal to our left, playing towards their own supporters in the Roseburn stand. There's 2 goals in 5 years at Tynecastle for Hibernian. This has not been a happy venue for them. Once again, they've made the journey of around 4 miles from Leith to Gorgie. And they know they need to make things happen in the second half, locked as they are in a relegation struggle. Well, the first half plaudits going Hearts' way, and rightly so. David Wotherspoon with an opportunity here. And McDonald did just enough. Driver. That'll be gobbled up by Lewis Stevenson. Releasing Tawiel. Driver making the run into the middle. Disappointing. Into the Gorgie stand off the boot of Mehdi Tawiel.
It's very poor in the end for Tawiel, but it was a breakaway. It was a diagonal pass by Lewis Stevenson. Jamie Hamill won the header, and suddenly Hearts are on the counter-attack. He expected a little bit more, you know, up against the centre half and James McPake. Tawiel should have got at him, you know, used his quick feet and tried to make something happen, but a disappointing finish.
I suppose Hibs have to take the view that they are only one down, and it could have been an awful lot worse. It was quite the one-sided first half in this derby. Hamill doing the defending. Sewers will leave it for Kujabi. Kujabi, who impressed Hibs after arriving at the East Main's training headquarters on a trial basis. He's had spells in Austria and in Germany, and the second division in Germany. Kujabi's throw. Very acrobatically by Ian Black. Beattie. Soares was alert to what was going on. Griffiths just didn't get going in the first half. Lee Griffiths.
Well, the Hibs players at least get out and started in the front foot. You know, they've made a couple of tackles, they've got a little bit of sustained ball in the Hearts final third, so at least Pat Fennin's team talk has had a little bit of a difference to them.
Have been input as well from Billy Brown. Obviously, a long time to Midlothian assistant manager. 23-year partnership at all with Jim Jeffries. Here's Soares with the defenders backing off. In goes Tawiel. Down goes Hamill. Free kick, says Craig Thompson. He is a highly respected football man in this part of the world, Billy Brown. Rumour has it he actually supported Hibs as a youngster. That debate goes on, but of course inextricably linked with Hearts. His work here at Tynecastle over the years, together with Jim Jeffries.
Guy Locke's been saying during the week that he finds it strange, and he says the Hibs tracker doesn't seem to suit him. So, yeah, that's what happens when you've been in a jamble for so long.
Hails from Musselburgh. I think there are quite a few Hibbies in Musselburgh. Early sparring stages of the second half in this Edinburgh derby. Perfect weather for the occasion. Hamill with it for Hearts. He tried to bring the ball under control. really has given Hearts an extra dimension since joining. That's the sort of player they needed. Focal point in attack. Once again, Beattie putting himself about. There's Soares for Hibs and Griffiths and Claros and Soares. He was impeded by Webster.
Tom Soares has had a good start to the second half. You know, I'd seen him play previously and he had done really well. He scored down at Kilmarnock. There was lots of good talk about him, but he, like the rest of the Hibs players, disappointed in the first half, so he'll be wanting to make an impact. And I think he's done that already. He's got on the ball a little bit more, Derek, and tried to make something happen.
Suffered a dead leg against Kilmarnock a few weeks ago. He's been on the sidelines. David Wotherspoon with the free kick for Hibernian. And it's a good one! Oh, it's Beattie back there defending.
He's everywhere, isn't he? You know, he's not just scored the goal, but he's kept his team in the game. It's a good header back across by Matt Docherty, but I think initially Hearts had held a very, very high line, Derek, and they'd left loads of space to put the ball into him. Unfortunate for Hibs.
Little swirl here from Hibernian. Wotherspoon with it. Now do Hibs have a goal in them? It's Beattie once again to the rescue for Hearts. Has been omnipresent today, Craig Beattie. Griffiths, clever flick on to Docherty, being chased by Black. Darren Barr doing his job defensively. Driver.
This is the corner kick that comes in. I think it's Matt Docherty again wins the header, but where's the Hibs players around the goalkeeper, Derek, taking the gamble, expecting him to win the header? I think they were standing waiting for the ball to come to him, and unfortunately for Hodge to get the ball clear.
We're seeing a lot more energy from Hibernian in the first few minutes of the second half. Beattie's gone down here. It will be a free kick. Hanlon was the miscreant. Here's Black. Very much the conductor of the Hearts orchestra today, Ian Black, in midfield. Darren Barr leaves it for Jamie McDonald. Could have been an awkward moment.
Well, I think we can see why Darren Barr's on the side there. You know, he's got a really good turn of pace. Many central defenders would have struggled against Lee Griffiths there, but Darren Barr showed quick feet of foot.
Starting to move the ball around with a lot more confidence now. Claros right on top of him. Scatchell. Here's McPeak.
I think we can say, you know, at last Hibs have came to the party, Derek. They've came to the derby. You know, they're wanting to take part, they're wanting to put themselves about and make an impact.
And ball the decision. Donovan trying to keep going. Much better from Pat Fenlon's team. Start of the second half, Pat Fenlon, who guided Shelburne and Bohemians to a combined 5 titles in the League of Ireland. Different job here in Scotland. Salvage mission, really. Trying to keep Hibernian in the top flight. 4 points ahead of Dunfermline, who are idle this weekend. Have tended to work within a budget. They've done that quite adeptly over recent years. They've overspent. There are many Hibernian supporters who might think they have brought out a bit more money for players, but this economy wants to say that Hibernian are wrong. Fake over there to meet Scatchell.
Well, I think it's about finding the balance, Derek. You know, it's about remaining competitive and trying to improve your squad and push yourself up towards the top half of the table, because Hibs are one of our bigger clubs and I think the SPL needs them to push the top 6.
Absolutely, Stephen. We do need a strong Hibernian here in Scotland, just as we need a strong Hearts. Scatchell appealing. And Sergio, the 12th manager to have served under Vladimir Romanov, if you include all the various caretakers. first overseas posting for the Portuguese manager. Griffiths soars away by Tawil. Oh, Kajabi, absolutely furious.
I think he's expecting a free kick, and I think we can clearly see, Derek, that it's a free kick. And I can understand if Craig Thompson's 50 yards away, Derek, he's standing 2 yards away and can't make what I describe as simple decision. So a little bit of frustration from Kajabi, and fully understandable.
Hearts players getting on with the job. That's the issue of timing of wage payments came to the fore again at the end of the week. It's Granger, shot from Hibernian, and Donovan went to ground. Craig Thompson saw nothing wrong. Here is Schatchel. Just wide of Beattie. Scott Robinson. Craig Beattie. Standing up to him was Hanlon. Corner.
Well, this is the hands on the back of Danny Grange, and I think when you put your hands up, Derek, you can expect a free kick.
Ian Black. Claros. That will be a free kick. Glad I thought it was shoulder to shoulder.
I think Ian Black's just taunting Georgie Claros there. You know, I don't think he was happy about the free kick award, Claros, but Ian Black was just letting him know in no uncertain terms that it was.
Well, that's with the massed ranks of their supporters very close to the action. Georgie stand regulars. Plenty of activity inside the 6 yard area. Craig Thompson is going to sort everything out. Ready to go now. Ian Black slipped after he had released the ball. Stack taking charge. Quickly forward to Bernie, and Lee Griffiths looking for a pocket of space. The boot of Hamill. Robinson. Good use of the ball by Ian Black. Here's Darren Barr. Andrew Driver. Granger goes in, up against Wotherspoon. That's a flashpoint involving Granger and Stevenson. Nothing serious, though. And a couple of yards were stolen. 12 minutes into the second half. Just the one goal so far in this derby from Beattie. Ahead of Soares. Certainly the Hibernian supporters way to our left were all on their feet just a couple of minutes ago, thinking back to that shout. A possible penalty, though I think it might have been just outside the box. Granger against O'Donovan. Another look in a second or two, cracks. Here's Hamill. It's gobbled up by Kajabi. That was careless from Jamie Hamill. Wotherspoon. Driver trying to get tight to him. Tawil. Too strong for Schatchel.
This is the incident you're talking about, Derek. And, you know, Danny Granger, I think, can count himself a little bit lucky. Naturally, not a penalty kick, but could easily have given Craig Thompson the option of giving a free kick in the edge of the box. So I think Danny Granger and Hearts have got away with one there.
Kajabi, here's Griffiths, trying to cause havoc. Wild, wayward, into the Hibs supporters. And Griffiths, who grew up following the club, born in Leith, Well, Stephen, you mentioned Gary O'Connor and the physical presence that he might be able to provide. O'Connor has been given the green light by Pat Fenlon and company.
I think so, and I think his past goal-scoring record will tell you that, you know, we can get in the end of something. But more importantly, Derek, exactly what you say, he gives him a different option. He can put the ball forward and he can go and challenge and be the main focal point for Hibs.
Inching towards the hour mark. Tense Edinburgh derby unfolding. Throw taken by Hamill. Webster across the defence. Hanlon. Well, it's Driver. It really came off for Andrew Driver. Sketchell was the man hoping to run onto the ball. Is the player to be replaced, and on will come Gary O'Connor. He scored 6 goals in 16 previous Edinburgh derbies. Hibs really need one from him today.
I think it's a slight change of formation as well. Roy Donovan is going to go and play on the right hand side, Derek, and it's going to be Griffiths and O'Connor up top.
Here's Black. Now Robinson. And Aaron Barr. Sweeping up. That's agreed a bit more easily. The second goal were to arrive. Hibs have made a better fist of it in the second half. Beattie. Trying to unbalance Kajabi.
Hearts just haven't been the same since half-time. Is that because Hibs have improved, Derek, or is it because Hearts have taken the foot off the pedal and becoming a little bit slack in some of their passes and some of their play? But I think it's probably a mixture of both, if I'm being honest, that Hibs have improved and Hearts have maybe just took the foot off the gas.
Well, Hamill wasn't holding back. Lewis Stevenson was his direct opponent. Kajabi, only taking the throw, something was hurled towards him. Scarf, I think, that section of Hearts supporters just in front of us in the Wheatfield stand. Ian Black. I often feel Ian Black really ought to be a border guard. He were to have an alternative career. It's the sort of man to check your documents, check your passport when you cross the frontier at Pilrick. Here's Driver. A free kick it'll be. 18 minutes into the second half. 1-0 to Heart of Midlothian. Paul Hanlon, excellent advert for the Hibs youth system. Rod Petrie certainly believes, and that ought to be the Hibs philosophy. You can say what you like about Rod Petrie, but that is a classic moustache from the heyday of moustaches in the 1980s.
It's been a long time since I've seen such an impressive one, Derek, it was. But just back to your Ian Black point. I think all round today he's been excellent. You know, he's been the patroller in front of the back four. He's been the playmaker from midfield, and his performance, along with Craig Beattie, has been very, very impressive.
O'Connor, the turn has gone Andy Webster. Well, O'Connor will offer something distinctly different. His power up front. 10 goals he scored in the Clydesdale Bank Premier League this season.
It's a nice tan, normally, Derek, as well. Normally a nice spray tan he offers as well.
Concerned here, Paolo Sergio, that Hibs have managed to ask a few questions. Ian Black. Stills header. Robinson. And Ian Black continued his pursuit of the ball.
I think Paolo Sergio will be frustrated because his players haven't met the standards they met in the first half. You know, I know he wants to play passing football all the time and getting on the ball and be, you know, be probably eye-catching, but you know, they just haven't fulfilled that in the second half.
Kajabi lofting it towards Griffiths. Down goes O'Connor. Webster. BT trying to get goal side of Hanlon. He wasn't too fussy about where the ball went for Hanlon.
He always asks questions, Craig Beattie. You know, he chases the ball there, he probably wasn't going to get to, but puts Paul Hanlon under enough pressure where he has to knock it out, and Hearts get a throw in deep in the Hibs half.
Beattie should get the instructions now to Hamill. Jamie Hamill with a short ball. Robinson. By Paul Hanlon.
You can just look around the Hibs team, Derek, and you know, you ask a question, do they look as if they have enough belief that they can get themselves back in the game? Apart from the cross from Lee Griffiths in the corner kick, there's been nothing really else in the second half to give them hope.
Kajabi's header comes to Webster. Wasted. Disappointing from Andy Webster. Coming up on ESPN after we're finished, it's back to Stamford Bridge. Ray and the boys, Chelsea against Leicester City in the FA Cup with Budweiser, their quarter-final. And next Saturday on ESPN in the Barclays Premier League, it'll be Stoke City at home to title-chasing Manchester City. There's Kajabi going down. He thought it was a high boot by Robinson. Rick Thompson has gone over to have a look at Pa Kajabi, Stephen.
Yeah, I think Scott Robinson just caught him as he cleared the ball up the pitch. You know, I think he's well aware. There was no intent in it whatsoever. I think it was just a kind of flailing arm that just caught him. And I think Kajabi was quite adamant that he didn't mean it. So these things happen. But, you know, he's done okay, hasn't he, in the game, Kajabi? You know, it's difficult as a left-back sometimes when you're up against attacking players to get yourself forward. He hasn't really took part in the game going forward. Defensively, he's done okay, but I think if Hibs are going to get anything from the game, they need him on one side and Matt Docker on the other side, especially to get forward and help the front players.
It's a lethal match against United last week after 63 minutes in the Scottish Cup as he was feeling ill. Remember, without Zaliukas, without Mrovic, two important players. Gary O'Connor not in the starting 11 for Hibs. But used as a substitute in the second half as they try to claw their way back. It's their capital rivals. Tiny play, Robinson and Scatchell. There's Hamill now. Have got their defenders deployed. O'Connor trying to winkle possession away from Black. Towell. Rudy Scatchell. Pickens at left foot. That was by Doherty. Chris Granger. Scatchell. The appeal from McPink in vain. Hanlon. There had to be a free kick against Lewis Stevenson. really has with Black.
You know, Ian Black really has had an impact in the game. You know, whether it's picking up second balls, whether it's, you know, starting the play and making things happen. He's been the focal of Hearts today. Craig Beattie's going to get all the plaudits and all the headlines with his wonderful goal, but I think the part that Ian Black has played with regards to Hearts' performance has been extraordinary.
It's easy to be one-dimensional when you're thinking of Ian Black, so often the pantomime villain when it comes to opposing teams. Here's Scatchell, and Beattie reaching out for it. Peg back there defending for Hibernian. Kujami. Kept it in, but didn't really help Hibs at all. Hanlon with Beattie, goal kick.
Yeah, good defending in the end by Paul Hanlon. He could have done down the side by Craig Beattie, but Craig Beattie just looking a little bit jaded for me, Derek. You know, looking a little bit lethargic at times. He's put so much into the game, defensively and attacking. A bit jaded.
David Templeton, who's currently injured, missed the three games leading up to this one. It's four in a row now with a groin injury. Is there a way through for Hibs? Well, they've won themselves a free kick. It's good work by O'Donovan. Tawil, not always really known for his defending.
That was good play by O'Donovan. He gets himself in off the side. You know, he's a central striker. He probably wants to play in the middle, so when he's put on the right-hand side, you'll find he'll drift inside, he'll try and take part in the play. He's got his side, a dangerous free kick in the edge of the box. And if I think rightly, I remember St Mirren scoring a goal here last week in the Scottish Cup, and it was from a very similar area, and Jamie McDonald in the Hearts goal, we want to make sure he doesn't get done the same at his near post.
Soares, Griffiths, O'Connor, all pondering this free kick. In need of a moment of inspiration. It's going to be left to Lee Griffiths.
Hugely disappointing, Derek. You know, I think he's got better quality than this. You know, I've seen him score some wonderful goals for Hibs and for Livingston and for Dundee, but, you know, when you're trying to sum up somebody's performance and how their game has went for them today, that's probably him. He just really hasn't been on the ball. He hasn't been on the front foot. He hasn't really had a chance at goal. And the first chance that he gets, he puts it high and wide.
Has real natural ability, Lee Griffiths. His Hibs debut in the derby here at Tynecastle back in August. Almost got himself sent off. It was Granger. That was by Claros. Webster. That's looking for the second goal that might just put this to bed. Webster's angle ball was an excellent one. Granger's up there. And Driver. Make the connection with the ball, Andy Driver. Soares. Paul Hanlon. Stop Granger, here's Griffiths. Important block from Webster. O'Donovan. Two in the box for Hibs, O'Connor and Griffiths. To a halt. It's poor use of the ball by Doherty. Scatchell against McPeak. Wasn't particularly subtle on the part of Rory Scatchell, but he thought McPeak was at it.
It's clever defending, isn't it, by James McPeak? Just puts himself between the ball and Scatchell, and any kind of touch at all, he's always going to hit the ground. So a little bit naive by Scatchell because McPeak was under a little bit of pressure, but easy out for Hibs.
Sporting a shiner, Rudy Scatchell, after the early clash with George Frankham in this Edinburgh derby. Might well be the final Edinburgh derby of the season. There's, of course, the chance they can meet in the cup final. It's looking as though Hearts will be in the top six. Hibs resigned to bottom six fare after the split.
Well, think if anybody's going to be happy at the bottom part of the table, is going to be Dunfermline. You know, they'll be delighted the fact that Hibs are getting beat. It keeps them within touching distance. They'll likely have a new manager in charge in the next 48 hours. So, you know, Hibs will really want to get at least a point in the board to probably to lengthen that gap.
Lefty Tawil. Beattie. Make it going to Hibernian. Kajabi. Tawil trying to dig in. Kajabi did well. It's O'Connor. Darren Barr on the back foot, stuck out the leg.
And it's good defending. I think it's Gary O'Connor just gambles and gets through, wins the ball, but unfortunately, again, for Hibs, there's not enough bodies in the box. You've got to look for a midfield player in Lewis Stevenson or O'Donovan from the far side. Got to get in the box.
Kajabi's throw. Do Hibernian have an equaliser in them? Griffiths, and O'Donovan, thwarted by McDonald. What an important save it was.
He's kept his team in the game, Derek. It's Lee Griffiths this time that finds himself in the right-hand side. He clips a lovely ball in. Roy O'Donovan gambles, gets across Andy Webster, probably for the first time today, and Jamie McDonald. He's had many critics over the last couple of weeks, but pulls off a great save and keeps a 1-0 lead intact.
More substance about Hibs in the second half, and Hearts have Jamie McDonald to thank for the fact that it's still 1-0 to the Jambos. Driver, want to line it up for Scatchell. It's a good read by Hanlon at the back, and away goes Tom Soares. Stevenson. Excellent work by Scott Robinson in the maelstrom of the midfield area. Klaros. It's away by Darren Barr.
I just feel as if Hibs have, you know, kind of got a second wind again, Derek. I thought they started the second half really well. They had a little bit of a dip, and they've now turned it again. Lee Griffiths has gone out on the right-hand side, and he's interchanging with O'Donovan. So, you know, Pat Fennin's trying everything. Try and get himself back in the game.
Danny Granger. Too long, too strong. Ewan Doyle's going to come on for Hibernian. 24, 6 days ago. There's Hibs in contention to win the Scottish Cup. First time since 1902, and Doyle knows a thing or two about cup victories. He helped Sligo Rovers win the cup in the Republic of Ireland at the tail end of last year.
He did, and I think this is the last attacking substitution that Pat Fennin's got, so it looks like it's all or nothing for Pat in this final substitution.
There will be one Irishman for another, Doyle for O'Donovan. Break it to Hibernian. Card is coming out as well. And Ian Black is no stranger to cautions. Kicked the ball away after the fact. And Ian Black's name is taken by Craig Thompson.
Well, that's the side of his game where he lets himself down, Derek. You know, he's been so influential in the game and on the ball, and you know, such a big part in the goal. That's the side where he's just gotta curve a little bit silly for him.
So Ewan Doyle, his first Edinburgh Derby appearance.
And substitution for Hearts in the field, number 8, Ian Black.
Also going to make a change as well. And after that yellow card, Ian Black's number is up. And he's very popular. Standing ovation.
He's got a knockdown. He seems to be walking a little bit gingerly off the pitch there, you know. With the game that he's had, if he was fully fit, I'd be very surprised if the surgeon's going to bring him off. So there must be a little bit of a niggle in there somewhere.
Ryan McGowan is on, Australian born, to Scottish parents. I know his folks will be watching back in Adelaide. Good thing they stayed up late. And here's Soares with it. Easy meet for McDonald. Insufficient guile from Hibernian. Peter Houston, the Dundee United manager. Fresh from his team's 2-1 win over Rangers yesterday, and they will be Hibs' next opponents in the Clydesdale Bank Premier League. Hibs at home to United on Saturday. Does look as though the top six pretty much in place now. The victory by your team yesterday, Stephen, over Aberdeen. Just about taking care of business, you feel?
Well, I don't know, Derek. It would be nice to get another couple of wins, I'm sure, before we can start thinking about consolidation in third place up towards second. But yes, yeah, very impressive.
Motherwell going very well indeed. Aberdeen will be on the outside looking in terms of the top six. Almost certainly now. Granger. Chase back for Doherty. Driver with an excellent ground. Into the clutches of Stack.
Quite an afternoon, Andrew Driver, hasn't he? You know, I think, you know, people remember him 3 or 4 years ago, always having a huge impact in games and being very impressive, but just hasn't been himself.
Now, here's Gary O'Connor offside. Flag was up. And frustration for Gary O'Connor. Just an awful lot, isn't it?
Yeah, maybe just a yard offside, but I think when, you know, Darren Barr does know the flag's going up, he doesn't know the referee's going to blow his whistle. So again, good defending by Darren Barr. There was question marks beforehand, could he replace Zalajuskas? Well, he certainly has today, Derek, and in, you know, the 80 minutes or 81 minutes has been, he's been very, very impressive.
It's a real credit to the Hearts players that they've been able to keep their minds on the football amid all the uncertainty. It'd be easy when you're not entirely sure if the wage is going to come through. And then, McPaik was just trying to get everybody out of the way. His teammate Klaros on the ground.
It was like an enforcer coming in there, wasn't he? You know, just pushing people off and jumping about. And I think he's maybe just trying to get the ball and get themselves back in the game. We can see, you know, it's a clear free kick. There was a little bit of roughing on the ground, but in he comes, using his experience, captain, sorting it all out.
Goes Soares, Hamill, showing it back. McDonald has it. Certainly based on the first half, supporters might feel it ought to be more comfortable than it has been in the second 45. Improved effort by Hibernian. And the card is coming out again here. There it is, Lewis Stevenson. He's the player who goes into the book.
Yeah, I think he's had a few little tackles and a few little niggles, and I think it's a clear free kick. I'm guessing the booking's not just for that one, but for the 3 or 4 previous ones I've had. But I think back to your point about Hibs being much improved in the second half, Derek. I think they just still haven't carried enough of a threat. You know, they haven't really threatened the Hearts goal enough to get themselves a goal and get themselves back in the game. And that's unusual because they're normally weak defensively and really potent in attack, but it's been the opposite today.
Scott Fenlon, having brought in so many players on loan, might have to start again in the summer. But the thinking is, on one level, short term, because Hibs desperately need to remain in the SPL. They know that, not lost on them. 4 points ahead of Dunfermline. Those two sides won't meet again until after the split. Robinson. That's opening up for Beattie. And finally, Kajabi moved over there. He's put in quite the shift today, Craig Beattie. He got the hang of this Edinburgh Derby stuff.
It is, and this is where you get your fitness from. You know, he said he hasn't played a lot of games over the last couple of years, but, you know, playing on consecutive Saturdays, playing week in, week out, that's where you gauge your fitness. And I think on his first half performance, especially, Derek, he's going to be a huge asset to Hearts in the coming weeks.
McGowan. Tangling with Doyle, the two sides together. Tonga were having to get out of the way. Just enough room for Danny Granger. Nobody there to finish it off for Hearts. McPate watching as it went through for the goal kick. Little bit more than 5 minutes of normal time remaining here in Auld Reekie. Hearts 1, Hibernian 0. Craig Beattie's goal, an exquisite goal it was. Killed the ball beautifully following Ian Black's pass. And finished with genuine authority. Webster going up. Beattie going down.
He's had a few bumps and bruises, hasn't he, Craig Beattie? But I think when you're a target man and a centre-forward, you're going to expect a little bit of punishment and a few kicks from your opposition. But he's certainly put himself about today, Derek. And if his goal is to win the match, you know, it has been a wonderful goal and a wonderful piece of magic from him.
Well, it's been feisty, just as we anticipated, 38 fouls. Surprisingly, three yellow cards. It's Granger forward. And Driver. And he's not going to get away with it.
I think Craig Thompson was edging towards the handball, but James McPate just a little bit hesitant. I think Andy Driver maybe just touched his fist, but it was
Oh, it's going to be a free kick in the position of Venezia, and the Hearts players are absolutely livid. Andy Webster in particular. That sets up another intriguing possibility for Hibernian.
And I think you can always tell by players' reactions. You know, Darren Barr quite clearly goes up, wins the header. Owen Doyle doesn't know he's there. You know, he doesn't know he's behind him. But for me, Derek, that's not a free kick. But there was certainly plenty of Hibs players looking for the ball. Griffiths went for it. O'Connor went for it. Kajabi. Tom Soares was looking for it. So at least one of them fancied their chances in this. You know, they've been so poor in parts of the game. But one piece of magic, Derek, is all you need. When there's only one goal in it, you only need one piece of magic to get yourself something out of the game.
O'Connor surveys the scene. Kajabi's move towards him. Left-footed option. McDonald frantically trying to get his defence organised. What can Hibs pull out of the fire? Dying embers of the derby. Thompson having a word with a couple of players on the wall. Soares is in there for Hibernian. Here is Gary O'Connor. And against that Hearts wall, him back out to Lewis Stevenson. A hit with ferocity.
It was, but the free kick itself, you know, very disappointing from the Hibs point of view. And Gary O'Connor just trying to blast it. Lewis Stevenson having a go as well. But they just haven't had enough, you know, they haven't carried enough of a threat. They haven't tested Jamie McDonald enough. And if it stays this way, I think Hearts have been deserved winners.
It's starting to go right for Hearts. They were in free fall for a while, but that victory at Ibrox against Rangers recently, I think, turned things round. Suso Santana, the Spaniard, is going to make a late appearance in this derby. Followed by McGowan. Oh, McPake in a bit of trouble. Just gets away with that. Rudy Scatchell was the Hearts player with McPake. Webster against O'Connor. Indications are we'll have a minimum of 3 additional minutes here at Tynecastle. Yellow card. Had to be, really.
I think it's complete frustration for Gary O'Connor. On one part, the fact that he didn't start the game, and the second part, he's came on and hasn't really had an impact. I think, you know, you could see from his chasing of the ball, he was always going to bring young Scott Robinson down and gets himself a yellow card.
Substitution for Hearts after 89 minutes, leaving the field number 19, Rudy Sanchez.
Substitution here for Hearts. We'll see Suso Santana come on for the ever-popular Rudy Scatchell. Scatchell picked up the eye injury early on, but soldiered on. He means an awful lot to these supporters. 100th appearance wearing the maroon shirt.
He wasn't as effective best, was he, Derek, really? You know, he was quite quiet. He's in the game in spells, but didn't have a huge impact and didn't make a big impression on the game. But, you know, he worked hard and put himself about.
Suso is the replacement. There'll be four added minutes because of the substitution there. Well, it's going to be 3 minutes. The officials deciding to tack on an extra minute. Now Hamill with the free kick for Hearts. BT looking to locate the ball. Suso. And he chiseled a corner out of that. That's what the Hearts supporters wanted to see.
You suspect it'll be a case of taking your time and holding the ball and keeping it in the corner, just trying to run down the clock because, well, there's only 2 minutes minimum left of the four allocated minutes. So I suspect that it'll be a short corner.
And Soares, and then referee Craig Thompson imploring Granger to get on with it. Andy Webster scored in the two previous Edinburgh derbies this season. Be averse to getting on target again here. Nobody there to attack the ball for Hearts. It's headed away by McPick. Webster away by McPick. It was misjudged by Robinson. O'Connor trying to burst through. Oh, good tackle. Redemptive tackle.
Just wonder, was that the last chance for Hibs to try and make something happen? You know, there's under 2 minutes left on the clock. The case of Hearts just trying to kill it. I'm guessing they'll just help the ball on in every opportunity and put it deep in Hibs' half.
Webster's header. Robinson there to meet it. Doherty for Hibs. Griffiths and Doherty looking for Doyle. Hamill managed to clear his lines. Corner to Hibs. Deep in stoppage time at the end of the game.
Well, this is it, Derek. I think this is last chance saloon. You need a good ball in. You need the Hibs players need something to attack. Kujabi's got to put it in a good area. Ask questions of the
Fenlon, giving himself the best possible view as Kujabi takes the corner. Nobody there to latch onto it for Hibernian. Stevenson, last few seconds now at Tynecastle. There's Claros. Griffiths. Well, down he goes. Well, Suso Santana, plenty of space for Hearts, still Suso, and that finishes it, the icing on the cake for Hearts of Midlothian. It was all Suso Santana's work, and once again, in the Edinburgh Derby, the talk of the town are the boys in maroon.
It's a wonderful individual goal by Suso Santana. All the Hibs players had pushed up. Lewis Stevenson tried to play offside. I think Paolo Sergio was trying to get him to go to the corner, waste time. He had one thought in his head, Derek. get past his man and get an attempt away. It's a great individual goal. It was Claros who got himself caught flat-footed. Suso Santana brushed him out of the way, and it's game set and match for Hearts.
Suso was booked for the nature of his celebration. I dare say he's not complaining. Certainly Paulo Sergio doesn't care one iota. It's happened again. Hearts prevail in the capital derby as more misery is heaped on Hibernian. Paulo Sergio makes it 3 out of 3. Suso Santana putting the exclamation mark on a Heart of Midlothian triumph. Craig Beattie had given the Jambos the lead in superb style, trapping an Ian Black pass and then showing the composure to beat Graham Stack. All ends up. Hearts surely now will be in the top six come the split. For Hibernian, the battle for survival goes on. It is finished here in Gorgie. Hearts 2, Hibs 0.
And thanks to Derek Ray and Stephen Cragan. Looking out to the weekend after next, it's more SPL action. Motherwell versus Rangers live here on ESPN on Saturday the 31st, 3rd against 2nd, both on the same points as things stand. And then the following day, Sunday, April the 1st, with complete honesty, we can say the Inverness Hibs game will also be live. That's 3rd bottom versus 2nd bottom. Here's the updated SPL table on the back of the Hearts-Hibs result. Hearts stay 6th. But as we can see, they're only a point away from that top four finish, which they desire. That's their average since the SPL was introduced. Hibs stay 4 points clear at Dunfermline, and not safe from relegation. Their place in the top flight of Scottish football is by no means guaranteed. OK, let's get the first reaction to the result now. Over to Keith Downey.
Ian, as a boyhood Hearts supporter and Edinburgh boy, how sweet a victory is that today?
Very sweet. Boys have worked hard, and being a jam, it's always great to win the derbies. And the wee man Suso just wrapped up at the end there.
How pleased were you with your performance and the hand you had in Craig Beattie's first goal?
Very pleased. We spoke about it just before the game, about the kind of pass that I played. And to pull it off, I thought it was a good ball and great finish and great first touch.
Obviously, you guys aren't getting paid. It's late again. How do you produce a performance like that under those circumstances?
Just obviously, we know it's hard, but the derby does it for us. You know, it's a big game, and you don't need to motivate any player for that. So, not everybody was hungry for it and put the wages stuff behind us and just got ready to play.
Well, thanks for that, Ian. You're the man of the match today.
Thank
well
you
played.
Very much.
Thank you. Thank you.